It's 2018. Where's my self-driving car? Oh, here it is.
This is Waymo, but you probably know it as Google's self-driving car project. Now, Waymo has long been considered the leader of autonomous vehicles, and that's because it's been working on this technology longer than any other company. Its vehicles have driven the most miles, and it has the lowest rate of disengagements, or instances when humans have to take control of the vehicle. And it's all been leading up to this, a real robot taxi service right here in Phoenix, Arizona. Waymo's been operating its self-driving cars in Arizona for about a year and a half. And during that time, it's even run them without safety drivers behind the wheel. Waymo's cars collect a ton of data, and Waymo feeds that into its deep learning algorithm for labeling and processing. And this allows Waymo to deploy what it calls the safest driver on the road. Now Waymo is ready to start taking on passengers and create a real business for itself. It works basically the same way as any ride-sharing service. You pull out the app, you pick your destination, and hail a ride. A few minutes later, one of Waymo's self-driving Chrysler Pacifica minivans pulls up. These are covered in high-powered sensors, like LiDAR, radar, and ultrasonic, along with a bunch of cameras, to provide a full 360-degree omnidirectional field of view. Waymo is calling its taxi service Waymo One. And initially, we were going to show you a demo of the ride that we took through Chandler, but truthfully, it was kind of long and kind of boring. Well, not entirely boring. There were these touchscreens behind the headrest that present a live view of what the car's sensors can see. Other vehicles are blue, pedestrians are white, and your trip is shown as a green line that the Waymo follows. It was pretty cool, but overall, the ride itself was uneventful, as it should be. It was like being in the back seat with a very cautious student driver. And sometimes it would take longer than usual to make a decision, like this unprotected left into a parking lot.
Now this is gonna be a complicated turn right here. We were taking a left-hand turn across traffic into this parking lot. So, you know, the car is sort of figuring out where it can go, when it can go. If there's no traffic signal or signage to tell us when to go, the car needs to make that determination itself. It needs to find that gap in the traffic. Waymo programs its cars to be conservative, to be safe drivers. A human driver probably would have gone right then. That might be comforting to some people. Other people might find that a little bit annoying and would want to see the car being a little bit more assertive. And that's something that Waymo is working on and has been sort of trying to develop its software, tune its software in a way that the car drives more organically, more like a human.
There were moments when the car acted more aggressively than I expected, but it was the type of behavior that you wouldn't notice if you were being driven by a human driver. There were jerky moments, sure, but it never felt unsafe, and I never felt car sick for that matter.
We want a service that is brings safety to all the roads. That's really the core mission, and it's around making sure that we constantly are tackling this problem of road safety.
So the company thinks it can build a real business by offering a safer, more convenient, and perhaps cheaper service than Uber or Lyft. To start out with, Waymo One will only be available in a few towns around Phoenix. And it'll be limited to just a couple members of Waymo's early rider program.
For Waymo One, we'll have an iterative approach that will start with Waymo train drivers, and eventually we'll take those out.
And when that happens, someone hails a car, it is possible a car with no one inside of it may roll up to pick them up.
That's our vision, that's where we want to get to, is somebody has that space to themselves.
Waymo One will be limited to only certain neighborhoods, meaning it'll be geofenced, and the cars will feature safety drivers behind the wheel, even though the company had said it intends to deploy fully driverless vehicles at launch. So as you can see, Waymo's approaching this whole commercialization thing super cautiously. And there's a good reason for that. In March 2018, a self-driving Uber vehicle struck and killed a 49-year-old woman in Tempe, Arizona, which is just a few miles from here. The Uber crash brought those early inflated expectations about self-driving cars to a screeching halt. But in the days after the crash, Waymo CEO John Krafcik said that its cars would have been able to prevent it.
We have a lot of confidence that our technology would be robust and would be able to handle situations like that one.
Cocky? Sure. But now Waymo has to bend over backwards to prove that its cars are the safest on the road. And it needs to convert a skeptical public who just doesn't trust self-driving cars. I've seen the surveys. People just don't want to get into these cars. But how do you make people believe that a self-driving car is safer than a human-driven one?
One of the ways, I think, is around experience. We are working on building the world's most experienced driver. We've now driven over 10 million miles on public roads in autonomous mode. Mm-hmm. That really allows us to continue to learn new skills, vet our current functionality, and test out with the most extreme and challenging situations.
So self-driving cars are supposed to be the future of transportation, but is the solution to all our transportation problems really more cars? U.S. cities are overwhelmingly dominated by personally owned vehicles, but that landscape is changing. Millennials want better public transportation and more options to bike and walk around, and they're getting that with dockless bike and scooter programs growing like crazy. And 51% of millennials don't think that owning a car is worth the investment. Just take Phoenix, for example. It's the 25th most congested city in the US, and drivers here spend 34 hours a year stuck in traffic. But the real danger is for people out walking around those cars, because Arizona has the highest pedestrian death rate in the nation. Between 2014 and 2017, 271 pedestrians were killed in fatal collisions. In 2018, 30 people were killed. Are self-driving cars really the solution?
Driverless cars do have the opportunity to reduce traffic fatalities because they could reduce a lot of the human error that leads to that. But at the same time, we don't really have any data that supports that just because the number of miles driven by driverless cars so far is so small compared to the data set that we have for human-driven cars. But it also kind of sidesteps one of the bigger problems, which is how our streets are actually designed and how they're designed to be unsafe for a lot of people.
So while Waymo's self-driving cars haven't caused any fatal collisions, there have been reports of some minor fender benders and even a few injuries. And Arizona drivers have complained that these cars can be a little bit annoying to navigate around. These anecdotes also underscore a really important point about full autonomy, cars that can drive themselves anywhere, under any conditions, that it may take decades for this to arrive, if ever. Even Waymo's CEO, John Krafcik, admitted this. He said that autonomy will always have constraints. Driverless vehicles will need to stay on the road almost around the clock to offset the cost of the sensors and the hardware and the software and the computer chips and everything that makes them drive without human beings. That means keeping these vehicles on the road for hundreds of thousands of miles. That's a lot of driving. And while Waymo's cars may not succumb to the same failings as human-driven ones, they'll still occupy the same amount of space on the road. Now, Uber and Lyft have been shown to increase traffic congestion in certain cities. What will Waymo's contribution be? Well, to start out, not that much. As the company eases its way into becoming a real business, its main focus is going to be keeping up with demand. I mean, people are going to want to use this. This is a robot taxi service. It's the future, right? So would you ride in a self-driving car? Leave us a comment in the comment section. And if you're interested in cars or the future of transportation, check out this awesome video that we just did about Tesla. It's on youtube.com/TheVerge. YouTube?